Hey, fitness friends. I was recently asked the question, what's better, kettlebells or dumbbells? And the answer is, obviously, it depends. Depends on what exercise you're doing. For example, if you're doing something that's swinging or flinging, or that needs to generate a lot of momentum from the floor, from your hips, you need to swing. That means using a kettlebell. If you're lifting slowly, doing concentrated curls, or doing double arm presses overhead, then dumbbells will do just fine. So what I'm gonna do right now is show you a couple of exercises that you really can only get the benefit with a kettlebell, and a couple of exercises that I only do with dumbbells. Let's start off looking at the deadlift. Notice how the handle on the kettlebell is higher than on the dumbbells. You'll see as I try to do the same exercise with dumbbells, my chest comes down much farther, making it a lot more strenuous on the lower back than doing it with a kettlebell. Now I'm doing the deadlift to clean. The shape of a dumbbell just really isn't conducive to doing a cleaning type motion the way that a kettlebell is. You can see that right here as I'm doing the one-arm swing clean with the kettlebell. If I try to do that with a dumbbell, well, it just doesn't really cut it because the dumbbell's not designed to be swung the way a kettlebell is. Cleans are really about controlling momentum. Here's the one-arm deadlift to clean. So this is really about using your legs to create that momentum so that the bell can fly up and then you control the speed and catch it in the crook of your arm. Now here's an exercise that a kettlebell is absolutely mandatory for. It's the swing to inverted hold. Great for the forearms and wrist strength. Then I'm gonna take that into the bottoms up shoulder press. Again, you can't do this with a dumbbell. It just won't work. It would be a regular shoulder press, where this one is all about forearm and shoulder stability. You can also put it together and do the swing into the inverted press or the bottoms up press. And then of course, the kettlebell swing. I've tried to do this with a dumbbell many times and it just doesn't feel the same. You don't get the same recruitment from the glutes, from the hamstrings. The dynamic moves of a kettlebell, because the weight is beyond the handles, makes it completely different than trying to do it with a dumbbell. Now here's the figure eight to the slingshot. Again, something you absolutely can't do with a dumbbell. You can't get that proper swing through your legs or do that slingshot movement at the end. However, what I always do with my dumbbells is this one, the squat to curl to press bilaterally. Now, this one does not work with kettlebells quite the same because you wind up doing a clean, which is great, but the clean is not the same as a bicep curl. And then, of course, just your good old bicep curls, the supinated position. I always use dumbbells for this one. And then if I'm gonna do it one arm at a time with the alternating hammer curls, same thing. If you try to do it with a kettlebell, it winds up being more of a clean and not so much a bicep curl.
So if that video answered some questions for you and showed you why some exercises just work better with kettlebells and others work better with dumbbells, give me a thumbs up, like this video, subscribe to my channel, and get more free workouts, more tutorials, and more nutrition tips. I'll see you next time.